नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी हियर सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स पार्ट टू एंड मैथमेटिक्स पार्ट टू वी विल स्टडी हियर नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर थ्री ट्रायंगल्स। फर्स्ट परपेंडिकुलर बायसेक्टर थ्योरम। गिवन लाइन एल इज द परपेंडिकुलर बायसेक्टर ऑफ सेगमेंट ए बी एट पॉइंट एम। Point P is any point on line L. See this figure. This line L is perpendicular to bisector of segment AB, and therefore segment AM and segment BM are congruent. We have to prove here PA is equal to PB. This PA is equal to PB. Construction: draw segment AP and segment BP. AP and segment BP. In triangle PMA and triangle PMB. In triangle PMB. Segment PM is congruent to segment PM. This segment PM is congruent to segment PM. This is a common side between these two triangles, one triangle PMA and triangle PMB. Angle PMA is congruent to angle PMB. PMA is congruent to angle PMB. Each is a right angle. Segment AM is congruent to segment BM. This segment AM is congruent to segment BM. That is given. And therefore, triangle PMA is congruent to triangle PMB. This triangle PMA is congruent to triangle PMB. By side angle side test. And therefore, segment PA is congruent to segment PB. Segment PA is congruent to segment PB. Corresponding sides of congruent triangles. Therefore, length of PA is equal to length of PB, means PA is equal to PB. Hence, every point on the perpendicular bisector of a segment is equidistant from the end point of the segment. 2. Angle bisector theorem. Statement: every point on the bisector of an angle is equidistant from the sides of the triangle, sides of the angle. See this figure. Given ray QS is the bisector of angle PQR. This ray QS is angle bisector of angle PQR. Point A is any point on the ray QS, this point. Segment AB perpendicular to ray QP. This segment AB is perpendicular to the ray PQ or QP. Segment AC is perpendicular to ray QR. Segment AC is perpendicular to ray QR. To prove, segment AB is congruent to segment AC. This segment AB is congruent to segment AC. Prove. In triangle ABQ and triangle ACQ. In triangle ABQ and another triangle ACQ. Segment QA is congruent to segment QA. This segment QA is congruent to segment QA. Common side. Angle ABQ is congruent to angle ACQ. Angle ABQ is congruent to angle A C Q. H is a right angle. Angle AQB. Angle AQB is congruent to angle AQC. Angle AQC given. Therefore, triangle ABQ is congruent to angle ACQ. This triangle ABQ is congruent to angle triangle ACQ by AAS congruency test. Then, segment AB is congruent to segment AC. Segment AB is congruent to segment AC. Corresponding sides of congruent triangles. One, example number one. In a figure, angle RST is equal to 56 degree. Segment PT is perpendicular to ray ST. Segment PR is perpendicular to ray SR. And segment PR is congruent to segment PT. Find the measure of angle RSP. See this figure. We have to find out measure of angle RSP. This where is R? RSP. Solution. Segment PT is perpendicular to ray ST. Segment PR is perpendicular to ray SR. That is given. Segment PR is congruent to segment PT. This segment PR is congruent to segment PT. Point P lies on the bisector of angle TSR. Bisector of angle TSR. Any point equidistant from the sides of an angle is on the bisector of the angle. And therefore, ray SP is the bisector of angle RST. This ray SP is bisector of angle RST. Angle RST is equal to 56 degree given. Therefore, angle RSP, this angle RSP is equal to 1/2 multiplied by angle RST. Now putting the value of measure of this angle RST is equal to 56 degree. Dividing this 56 degree by 2, therefore angle RSP is equal to 28 degree. To prove that an equilateral triangle is equiangular, see this figure. The given triangle is equilateral triangle. Here triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle given. Triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. To prove triangle ABC is equiangular means angle A is congruent to angle B is congruent to angle C. In triangle ABC, first statement here, segment AB is congruent to segment BC. Segment AB is congruent to segment BC. Sides of an equilateral triangle. Statement 2, and therefore angle C is equal to angle A. Angle C is equal to angle A. Isosceles triangle theorem. Statement number 3, segment BC is congruent to segment AC. This segment BC is congruent to segment AC. Sides of an equilateral triangle. Statement number 4, and therefore angle B is equal to angle A. This angle B is equal to angle A. Isosceles triangle theorem. Therefore, angle A is congruent to angle B is congruent to angle C from 2 and 4. Compare these two statements, we will get here angle A is congruent to angle B is congruent to angle C, and therefore triangle ABC is equiangular triangle. Thank you for watching this video.